Namaste. So perhaps that you have been outside on a dark night and looked up to see this beautiful white luminescent thing that is in the sky that we call the moon. And you may have felt that there's some kind of sense of magnetism or wonder. You're not alone. The moon has been something that has captivated humanity for centuries. And its mysteries continue to intrigue scientists and stargazers alike. For many people, despite so much technology and even the fact that we have visited the moon, its composition and influence on Earth have still puzzled researchers. And still, they are looking into how the moon actually influences us as a species. There's been a lot of probing of craters, mountains, and plains, and yet many questions remain unanswered, from its gravitational pull to how its subtle influence is working on us as humans. So, for me, the moon has always held a kind of awe, and as much as I love the sun as well, the moon has this special silvery beauty to it that is unlike the sun. And it was a few years ago that I began to really want to dive into how the moon's energy was working in my world. So many of the teachings from yoga and Ayurveda are coming from not from a person told them, but from observing nature. And from a yogic perspective, the lessons of life can all be seen outside ourselves, out in the macrocosm. As without, so within. That means that there's not a single problem that exists in your world, in your life, that cannot be solved or seen from without yourself, meaning that we can find the answers from nature. And so, what I did was I undertook a journey back in 2020, and that was to really chart the movement of the moon with my life and start to look at some of the lessons that were coming to me. So I wanted to share those lessons with you today and just give you a little taste of what I found and what was the wisdom that came from this more feminine and subtle teacher rather than the kind of blazing, blasting of the sun. So the first thing that I noticed with the moon is that the moon has a waxing and a waning, right? It's not a constant. Whereas the solar energy, the sun energy, is kind of on or off, and it's always on, but sometimes there's some clouds in front of it. But the moon is always the moon, but our relationship, as far as Earth is concerned, is different to the moon. And so we have this ball of light, just like the sun, but sometimes it's there and sometimes it's not. It has this ebb and flow. And the teaching that came from that was this, the idea that in the same way, my life is not a constant. It is an up and down. My energy levels are not constant. They're up and down. There is an ebb and flow. Some days good days, some days bad days, right? There's this place where sometimes I can see things clearly and sometimes I can't. There's a revealing and a concealing. And that ebb and flow teaching came from really being connected to whether the moon was about to become full or whether it was about to become empty. The second thing that I learned when I really paid attention to my own moods and my own way of feeling and thinking in my body, in alignment and being aware of where it was in the lunar cycle, was I noticed that before a full moon, I would want to eat a lot of food and I would want to eat a lot of junk food, maybe 2 or 3 days before the full moon. Again, I'm not a scientist, so I don't know whether other people have done research into this, but this was my personal journey of the 12 moons. And so for me, I realized sometimes when I would not understand why all of a sudden I wanted to eat junk food, I'd think, huh. Hang on a minute, there's a full moon in a couple of days. And so therefore I understand there's some influence on my body at a cellular level that is probably very primitive and probably protective. And so I'm not quite so harsh on myself when that happens. The third thing that I've learned from observing the moon and kind of living with it as a teacher is to understand the type of energy that I need when I'm working with some of my clients doing energy work, to find that place of almost being half asleep, that kind of twilight zone. And it's in that subtle light, not the light that is the sunshine on a plant, but the moonlight feeling, that I can really tap into hearing and having a little bit more intuition. And that's something that as a therapeutic body worker and a yoga teacher and a coach, I've really tried to cultivate over the past few years, so that when I advise people and coach people, it's not coming from me, it's not coming from my ego, but rather from some higher source. And being aware of the delicacy of the moon is what has taught me how to get into that energy. The last thing that has really helped me from sitting with the moon for a few years is this idea that if I want to have aha moments, if I want to make breakthroughs with a problem or something that I'm trying to create, perhaps something new in my business, I really need to be in darkness, right? So it's almost like I need the opposite energy of darkness to find enlightenment. I need to have quiet time and I really need to be rested. And these are all qualities that we associate with the moon. Many of us in the West have an association of nighttime as kind of boring time, dead time, downtime, lost time. But with my own journey, understanding that this is not the case. In fact, the richness is coming from the darkness. And I just feel that we don't get enough rest in the West. Even if we think we're getting a lot of rest just by 8 hours sleep at night, it's not the same as being able to lay yourself down under the moon and kind of having a place of surrender. And that's really why I created a membership. I called the membership Journey of the 12 Moons because typically there are 12, sometimes 13 moons in a year. And each moon is passing through a particular astrological sign. So as the moon goes through each astro sign, there's kind of a different flavor each month. I wanted to create a membership for people who were overachievers, people who found it difficult to rest, people who wanted to increase their intuition, people who wanted to step out of the fast lane and into a more mature and deeper lane. So this membership was ostensibly, how can I provide something to mark every month's new moon? Because the new moon is typically associated with bringing something in. And so I decided that on the new moon every month, I would teach a yoga nidra class online. And the yoga nidra class would change each month depending on which astrology sign the new moon was in. So it was multi-layered, and as far as I know, I'm the only person out there doing this kind of work, where you have this kind of subliminal rest of yoga nidra paired with bringing in the astrology work, paired with the lunar work. And all that makes it a very potent place to journey throughout the year and place spotlight on various aspects of yourself that might be ready to flourish. And instead of approaching them in a very hard, solar, got to do personal development way, rather lying down, taking 20 minutes, 30 minutes in a yoga nidra, where you're moving into a particular brainwave state called the hypnagogic state, That is the perfect place for you to have realizations, because your mental brain, your thinking brain, your over-worrying, over-anxious brain is not going to be on board. And instead, the moonlight, the softness of the practice can allow certain things to come up so that you can see them, whereas you couldn't see them before. So that has been my pleasure for the past couple of years, leading people through these monthly meetings online, teaching them and guiding them through yoga nidras into more rest, more intuition, less trauma, and the ability to release trauma, and just working a little bit more in the metaphysical and esoteric realms. So at this time of year, you might be running around either online on Amazon or in the shopping mall, trying to find the perfect gift for your friend that is perhaps needing a little rest. Perhaps it's someone that is into yoga and meditation. Perhaps it's someone who would like to do meditation, but finds it difficult to do meditation sitting up. Perhaps it's someone who's really stressed. Perhaps it's your friend who loves crystals and all things tarot and witchy. All of these people would love to get the gift of this year-long membership. It's $44 a month, and for that, you get a workbook that helps you kind of keep track of all of the insights and aha moments that come post-yoga nidra. You get access to the 12 videos that talk about the energy behind various astrology signs. And so each month you can feel the flavor or the vibe that is in the sky. And that's a great way for you to be able to bounce into some self-development work. And the workbook is there for you. Beyond that, there's a community. So we have the space that is off Facebook, off Instagram, where you can talk about things that have come up from your yoga nidra practice. It's a place for you to share when your birthday is, what astro sign you are, anything you've noticed as you've gone through this journey. And of course, over the year, you will get access to a library of yoga nidra practices. In each of the practices is a little bit of yoga postures followed by 30 to 40 minute yoga nidra. If you've never done yoga nidra before, I highly recommend checking out on my channel some of the yoga nidras that I have here for you. It is a super deep practice, and personally, I like to nidra every single day because I have a busy brain, because I can't stop overthinking. And doing a yoga nidra is the time that I can literally down tools and let my head kind of clear itself out. And that makes more room for creativity. Beyond getting the yoga nidras, the workbook, the community, the other thing that you're going to get is quality rest. They say that about 20 minutes of yoga nidra is equivalent to a couple of hours of sleep. So if you have a friend who's just had a baby or doesn't really sleep that well, and I know that sleep seems to be the hot topic everywhere at the moment, that we are not getting enough sleep and we're not getting enough quality sleep. If that's you, then I highly recommend supplementing, just like you supplement your diet with vitamins, supplement your sleep with some yoga nidra so that your body can get into this space of healing and you're not then in a deficit where your immune system is down, you're inflamed, and you start to have health problems in the long run. If you have any questions at all about Journey of the 12 Moons membership, or you would like to join us for the new year, then I have registration open now until the middle of January, and you can go ahead and try out some of my yoga nidras that are on this channel, or there's a trial for you within the Journey of the 12 Moons membership. If it's not for you, it might be for a friend. So start thinking about your friend who's an overthinker, who's tired, who's into the crystals and the metaphysical, who loves the moon, or who's maybe a little witchy and looking for something a little bit different for this holiday season. Wishing you all well, my lunar lovelies. Hari Om, Om Tat Sat. Namaste.